Today I'm going to go head to head with the inimitable Multiplier, and we are going to discuss our best ever music career decisions that have brought us the most success. Welcome to EDMtips. My name's Will Darling. I produce dance music for a living and I run EDMtips, which has helped thousands of music producers achieve some really cool things, like Danny, for instance, who hit number 2 in the Beatport Hype charts earlier this week. Nice work, mate. Glad I could help in some small way. So today I'm going to share with you my 3 best music career decisions that you can apply in your own life today to get results. And then I'm going to hand you over to my fellow producer and all-round English gent, Multiplier.
In my video, I shall explain why creating Mumbaton was by far the best music career decision I ever made.
You've probably seen him on the interwebs before. If you haven't, then you will today. First though, let me know, what one thing would you like to know about the music industry? Leave me a comment below and I'll do my best to help. Now, you can also download my free Music Success Action Plan and kickstart 2020 the right way. Just hit the link below the video for instant access, and thanks for subscribing to my channel. Okay, so let's get to it. My 3 best music career decisions ever. Number 1, becoming aware that if anyone else could do it, then so could I. Committing to be the best, really, because it pushed me beyond my capabilities. So I'll give an example of this. When I won my first ever remix competition, I basically had 2 days to complete it, and I said to myself, I'm going to win. Somebody has to, so why shouldn't it be me? Now think about that. This forced me to up my game. So I had a reference track and I was unwilling to give up until I got my track sounding as fat as my reference track. So to do that, I had to learn some new techniques and up my game in super fast time, because I only had 48 hours, right? So I went on the internet, I was like looking up techniques and just wouldn't stop until I got it sounding as good as I could. And I finished the track, but I decided it wasn't quite as good as it could have been, maybe 90% of the way there. So with a few hours to go, I stripped it back and reworked it and had just submitted it on time. But that extra 10% of effort got me my first manager and my first paid remix work and my first foot in the door with some of the big boys. And that led to my first signing. So the extra effort paid off like 1,000 times over, because most people aren't willing to put in that last 5 or 10%. So that is the first best decision. Just accepting that if anyone could do it, so could I. So the second is forcing myself to act despite being scared. Now, basically, everything I can remember doing in my life of any value whatsoever involved being scared. And conversely, the things that cause me the most pain and regret when I think about them is where I've allowed the fear to stop me. So an example of something scary was quitting my day job to DJ around the world. The gigs in the bands I've been in, the countless DJ sets I've played, the talking on stage at music production conferences, meeting famous producers and DJs, all of that stuff I found pretty scary. I've, you know, had the heart racing and the adrenaline and all of that, and I've wanted to kind of back down. But it's the same with EDMtips as well, for instance. So it's scary for me to make videos and then put them online, because you get shit from people, right? But luckily you guys give me loads more love than I get shit, so thank you very much. But the point is that if you let your fear stop you, then you're never going to achieve anything that you find worthwhile. So I guess in a way, the best music career decision I made in my life was to do what excites me despite being scared. And the fear is kind of the price of entry. So if you want to achieve anything that you value in the music industry, you are going to get scared. That's fine. Do it anyway. So the third best thing I've done, I would say, is starting EDMtips. And that's because it keeps me in the loop. It, you know, gives me great satisfaction to see the results that my students get. And I enjoy it immensely most of the time when I'm not getting shit online. So they are that, really. They're my 3 best career decisions. And before we hop over to Multiplier and see what he has to say about all this, drop me a comment below. Let me know the best decision you've ever made in your music career. So thank you, Multiplier. Over to you, amigo.
In my video, I shall explain why creating Mumbaton was by far the best music career decision I ever made.
Now, don't forget to check out Multiplier's YouTube channel if you haven't already for some super wizard music production techniques. He's a great guy. Check it out. Lovely job. And remember, you can also grab my Music Success Action Plan below this video and start 2020 the right way. I know we're still a couple of months off, but it's good to get your head on straight, get prepared, hit the ground running. Thanks for subscribing, and until next time, cheers and happy producing.